Good evening. Daniel Andrews has slammed the awarding of Australia's highest individual honour to Margaret Court. The Premier condemned her views as hateful and disgraceful. But moments ago, the tennis great returned serve. Dougal Beatty with the story.
A legend on the tennis court, a divisive figure off it. Now Margaret Court will receive the nation's highest honour.
I wasn't expecting it.
But the decision to bestow her with a Companion of the Order of Australia has ignited fury.
I'm like quite sick of talking about that person every summer.
With an exasperated Premier dishing up an almighty serve.
I think the vast majority of Victorians, they do not support that kind of hateful approach.
Over the years, I've had so much criticism. That it doesn't really affect me. And I think, you know, I call them blessed because I pray for them and I pray for my nation.
The honours are normally revealed on the eve of Australia Day, but this morning the embargo was broken online, leaving many outraged at the call by the Council of the Order of Australia.
You might want to speak to them about why they think those views, which are disgraceful, hurtful and cost lives, should be on it.
A winner of 24 Grand Slam singles titles, Margaret Court was appointed Officer of the Order of Australia in 2007. As a Christian pastor, she's been an outspoken critic of gay rights, marriage equality and transgender athletes, and is a supporter of conversion therapy.
The attributes of someone awarded the highest honour really should reflect the values that Australians cherish.
The criteria for the Companion of the Order of Australia requires eminent achievement and merit of the highest degree in service to Australia or humanity at large.
It's a system that recognises Australians from right across the full spectrum of achievement in this country.
The Prime Minister carefully sidestepping the issue, claiming he had no idea.
I have no official knowledge of those things. This is a completely independent, separate process, and those announcements will be made on the appropriate day.
Her views were denounced as demeaning by Tennis Australia last year, and despite repeated calls to rename Margaret Court Arena at Melbourne Park, the uncomfortable title still remains.
I think the sad thing is, they've probably never sat with me. They don't know the true story. I just get on with life. And that's what it's all about, is helping people.
Dougal Beatty, Nine News.
A Spanish tennis star who repeatedly complained about hotel quarantine is eating humble pie tonight after catching the virus herself. Paula Badosa is the first Australian Open player to test positive. Reid Butler joins us now live. Reid, you have some breaking news from the hot hotel.
Pete, the Holiday Inn is where people are taken if they test positive to COVID-19 in hotel quarantine. And just a short time ago, we saw a woman being taken inside the hotel by officials dressed in full PPE. Authorities not taking any chances. They told bystanders to step back as a potential COVID-19 case was coming through. I understand that this case is not linked to the Australian Open, likely instead to be a returned traveller who has been taken here after testing positive. There are, though, 8 active cases linked to the Grand Slam right now in the Holiday Inn behind me tonight. Among them, Paula Badosa, the Spanish star, who was taken here late last night after testing positive.
Paula Badosa made no secret of her disdain for Victoria's hard quarantine rules.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Restrictions the tennis star called insane. We can't even breathe fresh air, she wrote on Instagram last weekend.
She couldn't do a lot of things here in the room.
Well, now the 23-year-old Spaniard has the virus and she's experiencing symptoms.
It's certainly proof that the hard quarantine measures were necessary.
She's the first of the 72 Australian Open players in hard quarantine to test positive. Among those in lockdown, former women's world number one Victoria Azarenka. She told Nine News today Badosa's infection has had an impact on players' attitudes.
Yeah, I think it is serious. I think until it touches you, you think it's whatever.
Badosa will need to spend at least another 10 days in isolation and must be free of symptoms for 3 days before being allowed to leave.
The variants of concern, including the B117 or the UK strain, as some call it, that period of isolation is 14 days.
After her first night in the Holiday Inn hot hotel, Badosa appears to have had a change of heart about our tough quarantine rules, tweeting this morning, "Quarantine and preventative measures are pivotal right now. Sorry, guys, stay safe. I love Australia." And it's true, no one knows strict health measures like Victorians. Today we notched up 16 consecutive days with no local infection. infections. And if our good run continues, the Premier isn't ruling out boosting crowd numbers at the tennis next month.
We've got a process. We look at venues and events on a case-by-case basis, and that served us well.
There has been confirmation on guest limits at home, though. From tomorrow, you'll be able to have as many as 30 people over instead of 15.
And good news too for Victorians still stranded interstate. And travel restrictions with New South Wales eased significantly today. All of regional New South Wales is now a green zone, and Greater Sydney, Wollongong and the Blue Mountains has been downgraded to an orange zone, which means all you need to do is get a permit and get a negative test before coming here to Victoria. Now, the local government area of Cumberland in Western Sydney, though, that remains a red zone. Anyone in that area is banned from entering Victoria. Now, in the Sunshine State, Greater Brisbane has also been downgraded to a green zone. That means all you need is that permit and negative test. No doubt, very welcome news for many Victorians stuck interstate tonight. Pete?